Good morning, everyone. This is the sum in front of your screen, which we will be doing today. From the following particulars of Sonali Limited, prepare profit and loss account for 31st March 2017 as per revised schedule. Now, see, yesterday in the last lecture, I have explained you format of profit and loss statement. So today what we will do, we will be doing a sum based on the format. So let us read the question. First, what is given? Opening stock of finished goods and closing stock of finished goods. Yesterday I had showed you in the profit and loss account. Firstly, we will write the revenue. Revenue में it is revenue from operations, which is nothing but our sales. हमें कौन सा revenue मिलता है business operation से, क्या revenue, what revenue do we get from the business operation? We, that revenue is known as sales. And then if any other income is there, we will write other income. Then we will get total income. After once we get the total income, then in the expenses, we have raw material consumed, or if purchases is given, we will write purchases. And changes in inventory, changes in inventory of finished goods, WIP, stock in trade. So here what is given, what is changes in inventory? I had told you in the last lecture also, it is opening stock less closing stock. So हमें changes of inventory कैसे मिलेगा? जब हम opening stock से closing stock less करेंगे, we may get a positive answer or we may get a negative answer. Whatever it is, we have to show. Then purchases is there. We will write in the expenses, purchases. Ya fir if raw material consumed, purchase of raw material, opening stock of raw material, closing stock of raw material is given. We can find out the raw material consumed, that is the raw material used in the year, during the year. Then we have income. See, interest received and dividend received both. When we are receiving interest or a dividend, when it is received, it is an income. And we have two heads in the income. One is revenue from operations, which is sales. Second one, interest received and dividend received, we can show under other income. Then we have depreciation on plant and machinery. This will come under depreciation and amortization expense. Then for general expense, we do not have any other specific head. General expense, कोई भी, देखो हमारे पास क्या है, employee benefit expenses है, finance cost है, depreciation है, then we have other expense. तो this one, employee benefit में general expense will not come, but salary and wages will come because employees को we pay salary and wages. Finance cost में और interest will come, so interest on debenture आ जाएगा. Then depreciation and amortization में depreciation on plant and machinery will come. Depreciation means tangible assets का जब value reduction होता है, and amortization means जब intangible assets का value reduction होता है. So we have intangible assets value reduction, we do not have in this question, but depreciation is there, उसमें आ जाएगा. फिर general expense कहाँ पे आ जाएगा? Other expense, because there is no specific head for general expense, so it will all expenses which cannot be written in any specific head will come in other expenses. Then we provision for tax, ये profit before tax में से less करेंगे तो we will get profit after tax. Then transfer to general reserve and profit and loss account, previous year balance, both of them will come in the balance sheet under the head reserves and surplus. So transferred to general reserve and profit and loss account credit balance. ये हम लोग general reserve में transfer is done from the current year. When we get our current year profit, उसमें से we do appropriations. So this transfer to general reserve is an item of appropriation, means transfer of profit. So this will come in the reserve and surplus. So whatever appropriation is there comes in the reserves and surplus. Usme surplus mein, that is P&L account, reserves mein all reserves will come. Surplus mein we will write about profit and loss account. This profit and loss statement jo humne kiya usme jo final profit aata hai, that is transferred to the surplus as profit and loss account. जिसमें हम पहले balance लिखते previous year का profit and loss account balance, फिर add करते current year का profit and loss which we will get from this statement, and if any appropriation is that we will less that, like transfer to general reserve is an item of appropriation. तो ये हम detail में करेंगे when we will be doing the balance sheet sum. So now let us start. Name of the company is Sonali Limited. Then we can write profit and loss account statement. Profit and loss statement for what is the year end? For the year end, year ended. It is given here 31st March 2017 for the year ended 31st March 2017. So here let us prepare the format. We have particulars, notes, and rupees. Notes also we separately we show. So particulars, notes, and rupees. So we can, what we can do here, we will write notes to account. Notes to account में सबसे पहले in the profit and loss account we have what we say revenue from. देखो profit and loss account business में profit कहाँ से आता है? Revenue, profit या revenue business में P&L account starts from the revenue. Revenue means income. Business में income कहाँ से आएगा? जब हम sales करेंगे. So revenue from operations सबसे पहले, and revenue from operations में क्या आता है? Because यहाँ पे revenue from operations के लिए हमें क्या दिया है? Sales दिया है. See, only one item is given. So I am not preparing a separate notes to account. मैं इधर bracket में ही बता रही हूँ. It is sales and the amount is 5 lakh. If you want, you can prepare a separate note. तो यहाँ पे note number 1 लिख के revenue from operation, उसके under you can write sales. But only one item is there, इसलिए I am not preparing a separate note. इसके बाद next one is other income. What is the first? देखो business operations means business. Business में revenue कहाँ से आएगा? When we will do sales. So sales is given, that is the major income in the business. उसके अलावा other income. So other income में what is there? Other income में we have two things, that is interest received and dividend received. So what I will do here, I will write our first note, that is what? Our first note, I will write here. What is it? Other income. Other income. उसमें two things are given. What are the total there are three incomes. Main one is sales, which is revenue from operation. Other than that, I have two other incomes. One is interest received, which we can see it is 20,000. Then we have dividend received, which is how much? It is 5,000. Total is coming to 25,000. So I will write other income is 25,000. So we will get the total revenue. We will get the total revenue, which is how much? This is 5,25,000 total revenue. So we can write here, yeah, so we can here above we can show, 1 minute, here we can show. Normally in the format it is not there, still we can show here like this revenues. So here we can write total revenue, which is just for us to, this I am showing Roman one total revenue. Yeah, so total revenue here I can show total revenue. Here, total revenue, this I have got is this Roman one, 5,25,000. Now, second one is revenue में से क्या minus करेंगे? Expenses. Revenue में से क्या माइनस करेंगे? Expenses. Expenses में what first thing is given? Cost of raw material consumed. What is given? इसको A लिख लेते हैं. Cost of raw material given. Here 1 minute. Cost of raw material consumed, but this is not given. But what is given? Purchases is given directly. So raw material humne manufacture nahi kiya, directly we have purchased and sold. So in the format we have both raw material consumed and purchases ke liye bhi alag se next hum likhte hain. But here we do not have raw material consumed, we directly have purchases. So, main alag se, I am not preparing the note. Here I am writing note number one. Other incomes. Here, what is the purchases? It is 1,75,000. Then next one, humne already purchased. If you see the format, we have raw material consumed, cost of raw material consumed. And here they have directly given purchases. तो परचेसेस करके हमने ब्रैकेट में लिखा. रॉ मटेरियल तो डायरेक्टली हम फिनिश गुड्स परचेस करते हैं, सेल करते हैं. एक और तरीका होता है मैन्युफैक्चर करना एंड सेल करना, बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन परचेस एंड द बिजनेस सोनाली लिमिटेड इज डूइंग परचेसेस ऑफ फिनिश गुड्स एंड सेलिंग देम एंड डूइंग द सेल्स. सो हियर दे आर नॉट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. फिर हियर नेक्स्ट वन जो इम्पोर्टेंट है, दैट इज changes in inventories. Changes in inventories. And किसका दिया है inventories? Finished goods का. So let us go to our next note. Note number two. Note number two. We will write here changes in inventories. So, changes in inventories कैसे निकालते हैं? Opening stock change. What is the change? Difference. Opening stock of finished goods. What is the opening stock of finished goods? It is 1,50,000. Opening stock of finished goods is 1,50,000. इसमें से वी विल लेस क्लोजिंग स्टॉक of finished goods. So we will get the change. How much is closing stock of finished goods? It is 30,000. So I will write here 30,000 because less karna hai. I will get the answer 1,20,000. So changes in inventory is 1,20,000. Opening stock was 1,50,000 last year ka closing stock, but current year ka closing stock is only 30. So changes is 1,20,000. Difference is 1,20,000. Next, after this, we have employee benefit expenses. Employee benefit expenses. Employee benefits expenses. So let us check in the question. What is related to employee benefit expenses? Employee benefit, employee ko kya hum? एम्प्लॉई को कैसे बेनिफिट करते, विच इज एक्सपेंस फॉर द बिजनेस. हम एम्प्लॉईज को क्या पे करते, सैलरी एंड व्हाट डू वी पे टू द एम्प्लॉईज. यस, सी वन मोर थिंग, यहाँ पे ये एक नीचे आएगा एंड दिस अदर इनकम विल कम हियर. नोट जो है अदर इनकम का, दैट विल कम हियर. यस, एम्प्लॉई को हम सैलरीज देते हैं. एम्प्लॉईज को हम क्या देते हैं? सैलरीज देते हैं. तो हियर दे हैव गिवन सैलरी एंड वेजेस. ओनली वन आइटम इज देयर, सो आई एम नॉट प्रिपेयरिंग अ सेपरेट नोट. आई एम डायरेक्ट इन ब्रैकेट में भी, दिस इज फॉर यू ऑल दैट आई एम शोइंग इन द ब्रैकेट. That what is that one expense what is given under the head of employee benefit expense? It is salaries and wages. Then iske baad next head hota hai. Then the last lecture we have discussed finance cost. Next head kya hota hai? Finance. This is the format what we are doing. Okay. So next head is finance cost. Koi bhi tarah ka jab finance means to get the finance, to borrow the finance, what compensation we give in return? We pay interest, borrowing cost, bank charges, all our finance cost. To procure the finance, we will have to do that payment. So here what is related to any type of interest is given? Yes, for because we have borrowed money through issuing debentures, we have to pay interest on those debentures. Only one finance cost is given. So I am not preparing a separate note nahi kar rahi, because only one item is there. I am writing directly interest on debentures. Interest on debentures is how much? 5,000. Then, what is the last one? These are the heads, huh? ये सब heads है. कुछ नहीं. Next one is one more head is there, that is known as depreciation and amortization expenses. So anything related to depreciation, depreciation on plant and machinery. So इधर है depreciation on plant and machinery. Only one expense is there related to depreciation. Finance cost also 5,000 and depreciation is also 5,000. Now इसके बाद देखो इतना ही heads है. इसके बाद अगर कोई भी एक्सपेंस रहेगा तो वी विल राइट इट इन अदर एक्सपेंसेस. इसके बाद अगर कोई भी दूसरा एक्सपेंस रहेगा सो वी विल राइट इट अंडर अदर एक्सपेंस. तो देखो इज देयर एनी अदर एक्सपेंसेस देयर विच कैन नॉट बी प्लेस्ड इन एनी ऑफ दिस कॉलम. देखो मटेरियल से रिलेटेड परचेसेस में लिखा कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम, चेंजेस इन इन्वेंटरी और फिनिश गुड्स, ओपनिंग स्टॉक लेस क्लोजिंग स्टॉक, कुछ भी एम्प्लॉई को स्टाफ वेलफेयर एक्सपेंस, सैलरी वेजेस, बोनस, कंट्रीब्यूशन टू पीएफ, ये जो अगर ज्यादा रहता तो नोट बनाते, बट ओनली वन आइटम वॉज देयर, हमने डायरेक्टली लिखा. फाइनेंस कॉस्ट में एनी टाइप ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, बैंक चार्जेस, बोरोइंग कॉस्ट, ओनली वन आइटम वॉज देयर, इंटरेस्ट ऑन डिबेंचर डायरेक्टली लिखा. डेप्रिसिएशन ऑल्सो ओनली वन वॉज देयर, डायरेक्टली लिखा. अब अदर एनी अदर एक्सपेंस विच कैनॉट बी शोन इन अबाउ हेड्स विल बी शोन सेपरेटली अंडर जनरल एक्सपेंस. तो यहाँ पे भी सिर्फ एक ही है जनरल एक्सपेंस, अगर रेंट, ऑडिटर फीस, डायरेक्टर फीस, प्रिंटिंग स्टेशनरी, पोस्टेज, टेलीग्राम, ये सबके लिए कोई डिफरेंट हेड नहीं है. तो सब कुछ किस में आएगा? अदर एक्सपेंसेस में. सो जनरल एक्सपेंस एक ही है, दैट इज हाउ मच, 10,000. नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू, नाउ वी विल शो एज टोटल एक्सपेंसेस. एंड टोटल एक्सपेंसेस में कितना है? टोटल एक्सपेंसेस रोमन टू, टोटल एक्सपेंसेस इज हाउ मच, एड ऑल ऑफ दिस, 1,75,000, 1,20,000, 50,000, 5,000 प्लस 5,000 प्लस 10,000, वी आर गेटिंग 3,65,000. चेक वेदर ऑल ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग दिस अमाउंट. नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू, नाउ व्हाट वी विल गेट इज our third one, that is known as profit before tax. Profit before tax. Now, ये profit before tax में से हम क्या करेंगे? Less करेंगे. Minus करो. ये profit before tax कैसे मिलेगा? Total revenue minus टोटल एक्सपेंस. टोटल रेवेन्यू में से टोटल एक्सपेंस माइनस करेंगे, मीन्स टोटल रेवेन्यू इज 5,25,000, उसमें से लेस करेंगे 3,65,000 विच इज द टोटल एक्सपेंस. टोटल रेवेन्यू दैट इज टोटल इनकम में से, हाउ डू वी गेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स? प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स के लिए हमें टोटल रेवेन्यू में से, टोटल इनकम में से टोटल एक्सपेंस माइनस करना, दैट इज 5,25,000 माइनस 3,65,000. हाउ मच डू वी गेट? 1,60,000. वी गेट 1,60,000. नाउ लेस, ये प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स है, तो इसमें से लेस करेंगे प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स. Check in the question whether it is given provision for taxation. It is given 50,000. So, ye 50,000 we will pay to the government. Then we will get profit after tax. So, less karo, 1,60,000 minus 50,000. Our final answer is 1,10,000, which is profit after tax. Final answer 1,10,000. With this sum is done. Thank you very much, everyone.